Squatters have been living on this street behind me in New York, rent-free. News Nation getting exclusive access inside with the owner, and you never know what you might find.
For years, Donna Kent has wondered what's in the attic of her dad's old house. He passed away in 2012, but more than a decade later, the house is hers. But there's one giant hurdle keeping Donna from getting inside.
So I figured somebody eventually would show up. I didn't think it would take this long.
A squatter named Kyle has been living in the home for 6 years. That's him on the front porch. His face is blurred, but his intentions...
I understood the situation clearly that eventually someone would come back. And how would it make him feel if I told him I threw away their parents' property?
Hi, you're Kyle.
Yes, how are you?
In a shocking twist, the squatter opens the door for Donna.
Yeah, I've never been upstairs.
And gives News Nation exclusive access.
Oh my goodness.
Into the attic.
Be careful.
We're good. Go ahead, I'm gonna hold on to this rail right here.
Upstairs.
There's so much stuff everywhere. Let's see, this one says 1944. Look at this old car.
Pictures spanning generations. Unfortunately, most of the family photos are from her dad's second wife.
You know, at this point, I'm just sort of overwhelmed, to be honest.
From books to baseball cards from her dad's collection, she's sifting through decades when...
Oh, wow. I bet you it's somebody's ashes. I wonder if this is my dad's ashes.
Donna discovers several cans of what appears to be remains.
Look, more ashes. That's crazy, you guys.
She even tells the squatter. You can see his head popping up through the attic.
We think we found some people's ashes in containers, but we don't know who they are. Pleasant Plains Pet Crematory. Are they pet ashes?
Donna later determining those ashes belong to animals, and the attic is somewhat of a makeshift pet cemetery.
It makes me feel a little better that they're pets and not people up here.
Back downstairs, a huge sigh of relief. After years of waiting, but sadly not getting the closure she's been hoping for.
I've always felt like maybe there's something in there to give me some information, give me a glimpse into my dad's life. But, you know, so it's nice that I was able to get in the house and see it for myself.
Squatters, horror stories. I wasn't raised like that, though.
But you, by definition, are doing that here.
I am. Technically, yeah, that's what it is, but I didn't break in. I didn't come in illegally. It's just they stopped coming to collect the rent.
And not all squatters are created equal. That gentleman that you just heard from, Kyle, very nice, cordial. We're working on another story for tomorrow. We talked to three squatters, go inside their homes, and you will not believe how they justify what they've been doing in some cases for years, multiple times squatting in multiple homes. We're going to hear from these folks, hear what they have to say, Marnie. It is very, very compelling.
Right, and a lot of those interactions don't go as cordially as that one did, Xavier. Really incredible. Thank you.
Well, Natasha, I was expecting to see the unexpected, but really, to be completely honest, it wasn't what we saw that was most shocking. It's what we heard.
Half the island people are squatting.
On the streets of New York, real estate is like the Wild Wild West. At least that's what Sal Termina says. And when it comes to squatters...
Knew everything.
But Emmanuel, well, why would you do that if you didn't own the house?
How big is this squatting situation? How big is the problem?
So, in my experience, it's been getting out of control and accelerating.
Sal, a New York real estate broker, tackling the squatter situation one deplorable house at a time, like this one on Metcalf. A squatter says he's had this roof over his head for about 6 years.
What do you think about the whole squatter situation?
I've heard a lot of horror stories. I've seen things on the news of people like actually breaking into someone's house while they're going for vacation.
No,
we were given keys.
People are going to see this, man. They're going to hear your voice.
Mm-hmm.
And they're gonna be infuriated. They're gonna be mad. They're gonna be pissed. They're gonna paint you as the bad guy.
I mean, I can understand that. But again, like I said, I didn't break in.
Now to our second stop.
Five of us.
Five people live in here.
Five, yes, wow. Five.
A house occupied by five squatters for the last 8 years.
Somebody said, hey, there's this house. I'm sorry, I'm just trying to like understand, that's all.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, well, you know.
Robert, hiding his face, but not how he's living.
In their houses, I went into it, I'll tell you something. I mean, sure. The crackheads in there, the walls, they steal the pipes. I mean, What they do, you wouldn't imagine. So we actually a blessing.
That's the way you think? That's the way you see it?
That's the way I see it, okay. Yes.
And now to our third house.
Now, do you ever go into these situations thinking,
I'm gonna get shot?
Yeah.
Always optimistic. They said they're right here.
Black security camera matching the trash bag, covering the window. But before we go in, the squatter's aunt wants proof Sal is legit.
They hired me as a negotiator, so I mediate between the seller, the bank, and the realtor.
After about 15 minutes of back and forth,
after you.
We're in.
Oh my God, smells, man. Yeah,
and he's gone, he left?
But it smells like urine.
Let's just say the tour was short-lived. Back outside,
I says, okay, let's go open the door.
The squatter rolling a blunt, then sparking conversation about how he started squatting in the first place.
I can tell you the truth. I heard about the squatters right, you know what I'm saying, through other people, you know what I'm saying? I seen how they was doing. You know?
Three squatters, three very different stories that Sal says all started the same way.
Homeowner passes away. Kids are either out of state or just don't know what to do. And so
squatters targeting a dead person's property. Natasha, I don't know about you, but that is just seems like, at least hearing from these folks, just the lowest of low.
Yeah, absolutely. It is unbelievable, and we appreciate you giving us this look at this. Xavier Walton with that live report. Thank you so much.